Next is the concept of intersection of a line. Intersection of the line y equal to mx plus c with the standard case of a hyperbola. With the standard case of a hyperbola. Again, guys, the concept is pretty much same as that we had for an ellipse. What do? We try to simultaneously solve these two. We try to simultaneously solve these two, okay, by substituting y as mx plus c in the other equation. So that gives you x square by a square minus mx plus c whole square by b square equal to 1. And if you simplify this, you are going to get a quadratic equation in x like this, okay? And just by deciding the nature of the roots of this quadratic equation, you can actually make out whether the line is cutting, touching, or not even touching the given ellipse. Sorry, given hyperbola. Okay. So there can be three situations. There can be a situation where it is tangent like this. There could be a situation where it is cutting like this. And there could be a situation where it is not even cutting like this. Okay. So how do we distinguish between situation number A, B, and C? Just by looking at the discriminant of this particular quadratic equation. So I'm just going to write down the result. I don't want to waste time simplifying this. Okay. So if C square is greater than a square m square minus b square, it will be situation number A. That means it will cut the hyperbola. If c square is equal to a square m square minus b square, it will be situation number B. That means it will touch the hyperbola. And if c square is less than a square b m square minus b square, it will be situation number C, that it will not touch the hyperbola. And please remember, these conditions are very much specific to this hyperbola only. Only to be applied on the standard case. Only to be applied on this. Okay. So if your hyperbola changes, your situation will also change. Your situation will also change. Okay. Out of this, the condition number B is actually called the condition of tangency. This situation is called the condition of tangency. Right? And because of this, you can actually write the equation of a tangent, if you know the slope, as a square m square minus b square. This is called the slope form. This is called the slope form. Okay? So guys, a quick analysis about this equation. There is something very important about this equation. So when you say the slope form, which is y equal to mx plus minus under root a square m square minus b square, please remember one thing, that you cannot draw tangents with any given slope. Your slope must be following this restriction. That means a square m square should be positive. That means a square m square should be greater than b square. That means m square should be greater than b square by a square, or m square minus b square by a square should be greater than 0, which means m minus b by a, m plus b by a should be greater than 0. That means m should either be greater than b by a, or m should be less than minus b by a, right? In other words, let me tell you what is b by a and minus b by a slope. In fact, I'll just take you to the GeoGebra setup. Let's say I draw a slope of y is equal to b by a slope line. So y is equal to 2 by 3x, or 2x by 3, This is y equal, this is b by a slope, and y is equal to minus 2x by 3. Okay. So please remember, the slope of the tangent that you are going to draw should be either be greater than b by a or less than minus b by a. That means your line could have slopes of this nature. It could be like this. It could be like this. I'm just drawing the slopes. I'm not drawing the exact tangent. So basically what I'm trying to say is that this zone is the zone in which your slope should lie. If your slope happens to be lesser than that, what will happen? It will end up cutting the hyperbola. Okay. For example, let's say I take a slope like this. I can always shift this and make it a tangent like this. Are you getting this point? But if you try to take a line with a slope, this, no matter wherever you shift, no matter wherever you shift, it will end up cutting the hyperbola. Are you getting this point? So you can never get a real tangent. You can never get a real tangent if your m happens to be, let me write it, no real tangent. If your m happens to lie between minus b by a and b by a. So it has to be either less than minus b by a or greater than b by a to get a real tangent. And another thing which I want to tell over here is that, which many people tend to get confused, there cannot be any tangent which actually is tangent to both the arms simultaneously apart from these two asymptotes. So asymptotes are only two such tangents which are simultaneously touching both the arms. So these are like tangents to both the branches at infinity. So asymptotes can only touch both the arms simultaneously, and this point of touching is at infinity. Rest, no tangent can touch both the arms simultaneously. For example, let's say I make a tangent like this. Okay. Now this tangent can never touch the other branch. If it is touching over here, it will not touch the other branch. Okay. So no tangent can touch both the arms of the hyperbola simultaneously, except for the asymptotes. And for the asymptotes, they touch the arms simultaneously at infinity. Is that clear, guys? So what we'll do is we'll take some quick questions and wrap up this session, because I know many of you are having exams also. So let's take this question. Show that x cos alpha plus y sine alpha equal to p touches the hyperbola x square by a square minus y square by b square equal to 1 if a square cos square alpha minus b square sin square alpha is equal to p square. Done. So Lalita is done. So very simple. Use the condition. C square is equal to a square m square minus b square. So remember, C over here will be p by sin alpha. Okay, a square m will be minus cos alpha by sin alpha whole square minus b square. So multiply throughout with sin square alpha, you will get a square cos square alpha minus b square sine square alpha. Okay, hence proved. Next question. For what value of lambda does the line y equal to 2x plus lambda touches 16x square minus 9y square is 144. Please type in your response in the chat box. 4. No, that's not correct. How about Rohan? Rohan, any response? It's a similar nature question. Root 20. That's correct. Okay, let's apply this. First of all, we write it in a standard form. So 16x square by 144 minus 9y square by 144 equal to 1, which means x square by 9 minus y square by 16 is equal to 1. Okay. Now a square is 9, b square is 16. And for our case, our c is equal to lambda and m is equal to 2. Now it will be tangent only when, now since this is a standard case, it will be tangent only when c square is equal to a square m square minus b square, which means lambda square is equal to a square 9, m square, which is 2 square, minus b square is minus 16. That means lambda square is equal to 36 minus 16, which is 20, which means lambda could be plus minus root 20. That means lambda could be plus minus 2 root 5. Okay. So, all right, guys. So, we'll call it a day now. However, we have many more concepts left to be covered in case of a hyperbola. So, we'll be talking about other forms of the equation of the tangents, like the point form, parametric form, etc. Then we'll talk about the other equation of normal, again in Cartesian form and parametric form. Point form and parametric form. Again, repetitive concepts like chord of contact, pair of tangents, chord whose midpoint is given to us, concept of pole and polar, equation of the diameter, concept of conjugate diameter, concept of co-normal points. So all these concepts. And apart from this, there is a very small part of a hyperbola, which is called rectangular hyperbola, and asymptotes that we need to cover up. So I think the next class that we'll be having will be covering up all these concepts as quickly as possible, so that you are well prepared with your conic section part. And it's good that we are doing it towards the end, because these concepts will be fresh in your mind. Because they're done normally in class 11, then people tend to forget them. Okay. So thank you so much for coming online. So over and out from CENTUM Academy. Thank you. And best of luck for your exams.